I'm Vinnie Doshi from One Future Collective and I'm a clinical psychologist. Today I'm going to be talking about what are boundaries and how do we set them. When families, couples or even friends are living under the same roof for a long period of time without stepping out, it gives each person a chance to observe each other extremely carefully. This could go two ways. We get to know each other extremely well and we come out with a stronger bond, or we start becoming more bitter with each other and we become unbearable with each other. On any other day, having your own space would be very easy. You go out, you go to work, you meet other people. At the same time, you could just do a 5-minute run to the grocery store and come back and clear your mind. But how do you do all this during a lockdown or during a quarantine? Boundaries are the imaginary walls that we create for ourselves and for others so that we can coexist in a healthy manner. Setting boundaries gives you that space for yourself and ensures that you can live through the quarantine period. Now, there are some general pointers that you could follow when you are setting boundaries. And these are simple reminders for yourself and for others. Number one, identify the boundaries. Before you begin communicating with anyone else, you need to communicate with yourself. So ask yourself and answer to yourself honestly. What are you not okay with and why? And who are the people involved? It could be your parents. It could be just one friend. It could be just one parent. It could be and everyone at home. And what kind of things are you not okay with for everyone to follow? And if it is a particular thing with a particular person, you need to be clear about why that is. Number two, have extremely strong boundaries. Strong boundaries are not rigid boundaries. Strong boundaries are clearly communicated ideas. So that brings me to the third point, which is clear communication. Now, boundaries are not for other people. They are primarily for you. It's not about telling others what they can't do. It's about telling others what is not okay for you. So it could be some things as simple as you are not okay with an unclean house. You could frame this in two ways. One, telling the other person what they need to do. That would mean you can't leave the house dirty, you can't leave the mug over there. Or it could be something as simple as, I am not okay with the house being unclean. So either you pick up the mug or I will pick up the mug. And that is where we set clear communication. You tell them what is not okay for you and you tell them that extremely clearly. And the fourth point is having connections with yourself. When you have a boundary, you create a space for yourself. What you do in that space is majorly up to you. Identify what you want to do with yourself. Do you want to create something for yourself, or are you just okay with being present in that moment? It's not necessary that you need to do something with that space. Just being present and mindful is enough as well. But that's up to you. Not everyone at home will understand the concept of boundaries. So it wouldn't be the best idea to tell everyone that, okay, we need to have boundaries at the dinner table. Sometimes this direct conversation works, but when it doesn't, here's what you can do. Number one, have a collaborative rule setting at home. So you need to be telling everyone at home that, we need to set some ground rules because we're all going to be sharing this common workspace. It's like going to a co-working space where they have their set ground rules and you abide by them. Similarly, when you're at home, it does become a co-working space. You are all at home. Each person needs their own space, needs their own way of things. So you set rules in a collaborative way. You could have siblings at home or children, or you could have parents, over-involved parents as well. Get everyone together and set the ground rules. When we do it in a collaborative manner, it helps everyone to take personal responsibility. And this is also the space where you and everyone else will be able to share what your own personal idea of space is. Set a designated physical space. During quarantine, physical spaces are extremely important for boundaries to follow through. It could be either a spot on a sofa, it could be the balcony, the room, kitchen, or even a singular part of the room. The idea is to own the space. If you are stressed or overwhelmed, that is your space and no one gets to call you when you are in there. So if you are sitting in the corner of the room and everybody in the house knows that that is your corner of the room, they can't call you. If they do, you go back to the first step where we set collaborative rules and you go back to the consequences. What happens when someone breaks a rule? So if you're in your space and someone invades your space, what do you do then? Division of labor. Each person is responsible for duty that is assigned to them and they do it in their own way. Keep boundaries. So this is where I come in saying that boundaries are not just about allowing each other the space, but it's also about allowing each other the space to do things in their own way. The way you clean the house would not be the same as somebody else cleaning the house. The way you cook food would not be the same as somebody else cooking the food. So cutting vegetables, you do it your way, I do it my way. It's as simple as that. It takes a lot of effort. The fourth point that I come to now is different boundaries for different people. Your expectations of personal space may be different for either your mom than it is for your siblings. Allow yourself to feel differently around different people. There's no harm in feeling that way. Being a family does not mean that you have the same feelings for everyone. It is important that you communicate clearly. You can say something like, I'm not okay for my mom to come into the room, but I'm okay if my sister or my brother comes into the room while I'm working. That could be because you have a mutual understanding, an unspoken understanding between yourselves. Identify your space in the drama triangle and step out of the drama triangle. When you set boundaries, it does not mean that there will not be conflict or heated arguments. The drama of such conflicts usually forms a drama triangle. This is the drama triangle. So if you look at the drama triangle, we're talking about a rescuer, we're talking about a persecutor, and we're talking about a victim. The rescuer is someone who is always going to feel like they know the best for everyone. They have difficulty saying no, and they often overcompensate and they do more things than they are expected to do. The persecutor, on the other hand, is someone who is extremely critical, blames others, often seen as a bully. They can be extremely sarcastic and they can have an authoritative stance as well. The victim is somebody who feels extremely helpless, hopeless, or at least portrays themselves that way. They have this thing of, I can't do it, I don't know how to do it. And that is when the rescuer will come in for them. And when the victim doesn't do something right, the persecutor is going to blame them, saying that you're not doing this right. The rescuer will rescue them. The victim is going to take a lot of chance over here and be like, I can't do it, so you do it for me, or you do it for me. And that is when you realize what you are in the drama triangle and you recognize what you're doing and you step out of it. When you step out, once you know what role you're taking on, it is easier to step out of it and move into your personal space. The point is to allow yourself to move into your designated space and move out of the drama triangle. The moment you break any single person's rule, each of the other person is going to be confused and going to wonder, what do we do next? And that is when the drama starts breaking down by itself. So you take charge. The whole point of boundaries is that you take charge for yourself, communicate with others, and at the same time allow others to be responsible for themselves as well. Now, I know that each of that, that not everyone is going to be able to do all of these things, but we hope that even one of these things has helped you. And if you have any doubts, you can reach us on, or if you have any comments, doubts, you can always reach us on our social media sites on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and feel free to reach out to us at any point. Thank you.